आप वही रहते मेरे बाद मुझे करता था मैं तो मेरा उसको फोन करना था मैंने कर दिया उसको उसको
Ladies and gentlemen, the academic procession will now enter the convocation hall. You are all requested to stand and keep standing till the members of the board of management have taken their seats on the dais. May I request you to switch off your mobile phone for the entire duration of the convocation to avoid disturbance to the proceedings.
With the permission of the Chancellor, I hereby declare the fourth convocation of the University open.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I request you to welcome the chief guest, all the dignitaries, guests, and the graduates present in the convocation hall, and to present a report on the major activities of the University during the last 1 year.
Chief guest, Dr. Subramanian Swami, former Union Cabinet Minister, Justice S.M. Bhargav, Chancellor of the IIS University, members of the statutory bodies of the university, distinguished guests, representatives of the media, colleagues, and dear graduates. It's a great privilege and honor to welcome you all to the fourth convocation of the IIS University. Ladies and gentlemen, today is a time for celebrations. Acknowledging the success of our graduates who have reached an important milestone in their lives. Today is a time for jubilations, toasting the triumph of our achievers who are going to turn a new page in their careers. But more importantly, I say, today is a time for appreciation, a time to be grateful to teachers, parents, families and friends, as this achievement is one that is seldom managed without support of those nearest to us. Amongst all this cheer and festivity, I have the honor of welcoming and introducing a renowned academician who has, in his life and work, defied categorization. And as I stand before you, ironically, I am faced with a dilemma. How do I put in prose the multi-splendored personality and diverse achievements of a man whose mastery over the written and spoken words is legendary? He is not only an economist, academician, politician, and a writer par excellence, but is also one of the most eminent and conscientious citizens of our times. A champion of fair dealings and transparency, he displays an unwavering commitment to democracy, rule of law, and ethical values in public life. His writings over a wide gamut of issues, he articulates his views with exceptional lucidity. He is truly a Renaissance man. In the words of the great poet Josiah Evelyn, he is a tall man, sun crowned with a strong mind, true faith, and willing hands, who lives above the fog in public duty and private thinking. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Dr. Subramanian Swami. His oratory is eloquent. His brilliance is his best variety. I'm sure the convocation address to be delivered by such an illustrious personality will inspire our young, bright graduates to achieve excellence in their chosen fields. Martin Luther King had once opined that while the function of education is to teach one to think intelligently and critically, intelligence plus character, that is the goal of education. The IIS University was started with this holistic vision, the vision of creating a center of academic and extracurricular achievements for the youth, of providing a context that emancipates the intellect and the spirit of zealously guarding a space that develops critical thinking and rescues the imagination. The journey began in 1995 at the International College for Girls, and within a short span of time crossed many significant milestones in its endeavors towards excellence in higher education. It was conferred the status of Dean to University by the Ministry of Human Resource Development in 2009. While the institution has grown in terms of size, reputation and impact, we remain true to our values of social inclusion with a strong sense of place and civic responsibility. A review committee constituted by the MHRD has also reaffirmed our commitment to delivering quality education by placing the IIS University among the top 38 deemed universities of the country under Category A. A significant achievement in this academic year has been the grant of 12B status to the university by the University Grants Commission, New Delhi. the journey began well, has infinite potential to evolve further, setting newer standards of excellence. The student enrollment during the past year has risen from 4,000 to over 5,000. There is also a corresponding expansion in the strength of the permanent staff, with more than 80% holding a PhD degree. The university strives to maintain its cosmopolitan and pluralistic tradition by enrolling young scholars and faculty from varied communities and socio-economic backgrounds. We believe a diversity is a source of strength that underpins the exchange of ideas, innovation, and debate at the heart of our academic mission. Of all its core values, the university has remained true to its first, that is, the academic rigor. The university emphasizes the sciences, humanities, social sciences, commerce, management, and IT, offers a unique combination of resources in a space that provides unusual intellectual and cultural opportunities and a context of learning that enhances professionalism, humanism, and social responsibility. The education system followed here has a clear interface with the society in all its endeavors. This is abundantly brought out by the kind of academic research that is pursued here, as well as the co-curricular activities undertaken. The university has adopted a proactive approach towards building its portfolio of academic partnerships through the development of sustainable and mutually beneficial alliances with highly regarded organizations that share common aims and interests. These partnerships have benefited the faculty and students alike and have extended and enhanced national and global reach and reputation. Research is the foundation of all that we do here at the IIS University. As part of our commitment to strengthening our already impressive research base, we have established a Center for Research, Innovation and Training, instituted research scholarships across disciplines, and launched a research development fund in order to add a voice to the intellectual dialogue both within the university community and in broader academia. The university has taken the initiative to publish peer-reviewed journals in all the faculties, which include original multidisciplinary articles. After the grant of Dean University status, we have started recent programs in all the faculties. We can boast of the commendable performance of our faculty members, particularly their quality research output, which has evinced many publications in various peer-reviewed national and international journals, as well as conference proceedings, books, monographs, etc. Their research has been widely published and referenced, both locally and internationally. Besides teaching and research, the university continues to initiate academic activities pertaining to new and frontier technology areas of societal importance by actively engaging faculty from all departments in consultancy services for external organizations. The faculty members also provide academic leadership through their inputs as external members on various statutory bodies and editorial boards of the organizations of national repute. The academic excellence and breadth of curricula at the university help to mold professionals and provide a perfect springboard for their entry into the world at work arena. We are extremely pleased to announce that in the current year, an impressive number of our students have been successfully placed by an active counseling and placement cell in several prestigious universities and organizations. Besides this, the university has also been able to achieve substantial results in creating successful and innovative entrepreneurs. Today, is a proud day for this university. Over 1,500 students are being conferred their degrees and diplomas in the various programs, out of which there are 31 PhDs, 1 MPhil, 473 post-graduation, 922 undergraduation, and 78 advanced diploma and PG diploma level graduates. I am privileged to state that 62 gold medals and plaques, 12 endowment awards, and 289 medal certificates are being awarded to meritorious graduates. I extend my heartiest congratulations to all of them. Dear graduates, I take this opportunity to congratulate you all on your success. May I say that having the degrees, diplomas and certificates today is just the beginning. The real challenge of life starts now. You have to build your career and set goals to accomplish something worthwhile in life. My advice to you all is what Hillary Clinton had once said, being a true woman means never giving up on yourself, your potential, your future. It means getting up, working hard, and putting a country or a community on your back. So be bold and break new ground. Embrace the challenges and get ahead of the change. Find your purpose and take your share in shaping the new world. Become creators of the future. Be a trailblazer rather than a follower. It is said that most people are like mirrors, reflecting the moods and emotions of the times. Few are windows, bringing light to bear on the dark corners where fester. I am confident that all of you will be windows of light to others around you. Also keep in mind, you are an image to the public. Live up to the ISU core values of honesty and integrity, innovativeness, excellence, intellectual freedom, equity, and social and environmental responsibility. So go out, do well, but most importantly, do good. Once you receive your degree or diploma, you become part of the community of gold as rights. I welcome you to this ever-growing and diverse network, and I invite you to join Bandhan, the Association of the Alumni of this university, so that you can stay connected with your alma mater. I wish you success in all your endeavors as you enter the world of work and life. Generally, it will be worth reflecting on these lines by Emerson. To laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people, to earn the appreciation of honest critics, and endure the betrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty, to find the best in others, to leave the world a bit better, and to know even one life has breathed easier, you have lived. This is to have succeed. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you, sir. In my capacity as the registrar of the university, I request the Dean, Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences now, to present the graduates in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences for conferment of their degrees and diplomas by the Chancellor. I request the Dean to present the recipients of the research degrees of PhD and MPhil first, and then the merit position holders of different programs at postgraduate level, and thereafter the merit position holders of the professional, honors, and pastors programs at the undergraduate level for award of degrees in person. Merit position holders of different advanced diploma courses of career-oriented and skill development programs may then be presented for the award of diplomas in person. After that, all the graduates in the faculty may be presented for conferment of their degrees by the Chancellor. Professor M.K. Jain, Dean, Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Mr. Chancellor, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace passed by the Academic Council and the Board of Management of the IIS University, the temple, whose names are here submitted for award of the degrees of PhD and MPhil, the merit position holders of different programs of the postgraduate level, professional honors and past course programs of the undergraduate level, and different advanced diploma courses of career-oriented and skill development programs in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences of this university for the award of degrees and diplomas in person.
As much as already invested in me, as a chancellor of the IIS University, I hereby grant permission for presenting the recipients of the research degree of PhD and MPhil, merit position holders of different programs at a postgraduate level, professional honors, and past course programs at the undergraduate level, and different advanced diploma courses of career-oriented and skill development programs in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences, for whom approval has been accorded by the Academic Council and the Board of Management of the Award of Degree and Diploma in person.
For receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Arts in person, I call upon Poonam Sethi. Sucharita Sharma. For receiving the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Social Sciences in person, I call upon Asta Saxena. Aditi Kaul. Sharma, Archana, Chetna Lakotia. Nandini Paul. Sonal Jain. For receiving the degree of Master of Philosophy in Social Sciences in person, I call upon Kokila Chaturvedi. Now I invite the merit position holders of professional programs at the postgraduate level in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences for receiving their degrees in person. Position holders in their order of merit in the program Master of Journalism and Mass Communication, Anshika Natani. Nikita Batra. Ruchi Bhatia, Neha Sharma, FIFA B. Position holders in the order of merit in the program Master of Visual Arts are Hani Dhawan. Dipali Sharma. Pooja Paliwal. Akshita Sharma. And Shreya Godavar. Now I invite the rank position holders of other programs at the postgraduate level in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences for receiving their degrees in person. Position holders in the order of merit in the program Master of Arts Economics are Nithi Dugal, Monica and Karishma Jain, position holders in the order of merit in the program Master of Arts English are Khushbu Sharma, Kamal Chhabra, Palak Bindal, and Shreya Tavar. Position holders in the order of merit in the program Master of Arts Sociology are Hiran Mehta, Preeti Chaudhary, and Vinisha Raj Soil. Now I invite the rank position holders of professional programs at the undergraduate level in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences for receiving their degrees in person. Position holders in their order of merit in the program Bachelor of Journalism and Mass Communication are Anjali Saxena, Vishaka Kabra, Sita Bharti, Monica Vijay, and Anubha Jain. position holders in the order of merit in the program Bachelor of Art, Visual Arts are Risha Parasrampuria, Prakriti Filnani, Megha Bhagiria, Alpna Rai, and Manika Sharma. Now I invite the merit position holders of honors and past course programs at the undergraduate level in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences for receiving their degrees in person. Position holders in their order of merit in the program Bachelor of Arts Honors in Economics are Dimple Jignani, Purva Bangar, Divya Singh, Simran Nagra. Position holders in their order of merit in the program Bachelor of Arts Honors in English are Ravisha Rathore, Ishita Malhotra, Palak Juneja, Rupal Jain, and Taksha Gupta. Position holders in their order of merit in the program Bachelor of Arts Honors in Political Science are Ankita Meera, and Mahima Kumari Kirchi. Position holders in their order of merit in the program Bachelor of Arts Honors in Psychology are Dipali Das, Sneha John, Ankita Kabra, Diksha Thapar, and Sugandha Nagar. Position holders in their order of merit for the degree of Bachelor of Arts are Abhilasha Saxena, Jyoti Yadav, Nandini Joshi, Garima Goyal, Tanushree Paliwala, Aditi Sharma, Rashmi Shekhawat, Nikita Saharan, Divyanshi Garg, and Grishma Meena. Now I invite the merit position holders of various advanced diploma courses of career-oriented and skill development programs in the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences for the award of diplomas in person. Position holders in the advanced diploma program in fashion designing are Shubhangi Pandey, Diksha Parikh. Rashi Shekhavat. Sonia Tiwari. And Shen Shikhar. First position holder in the Advanced Diploma Program in French is Meenakshi Narayanan. First position holder in the Advanced Diploma Program in Jewelry Designing is Jigyasa Goel. Position holder in the Advanced Diploma in Mass Communication and Video Production is Arzu Pathan. All graduates of Arts and Social Sciences, please rise. Mr. Chancellor, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grades passed by the Academic Council and the Board of Management, the candidates whose names are herewith submitted for conferment of their degrees and diplomas. Poonam Sethi and Sucharita Sharma for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Arts, Asta Saxena, Aditi Paul, Aparna Sharma, Archana Chaitna Lakotia, Nandini Paul, Sonal Jain, and Sudha Rathod for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Sciences, Kokila Chaturvedi for the degree of Master of Philosophy in Social Sciences, Shruti Mishra and two others for the degree of MA in Fashion Technology, Abhishcha Verma and 15 others for the degree of Master of Journalism and Mass Communication, Garima Jain and four others for the degree of Master of Social Work, Akshita Sharma and nine others for the degree of Master of Visual Arts, Herman Kaur and three others for the degree of MA in Economics, Apurva Sharma and 17 others for the degree of MA in English, Anshul Modani and 21 others for the degree of MA in Psychology, Anju and 5 others for the degree of MA in Sociology, Anjali Saxena and 23 others for the degree of Bachelor of Journalism and Mass Communication, Ashok Chawla and 24 others for the degree of Bachelor of Visual Arts, Ansel Andrews and 20 others for the degree of BA Honours in Economics, Ashwarya Krishna Kumari Rajavar and 31 others for the degree of BA Honours in English, Monica and 6 others for the degree of BA Honours in Political Science, Abhilasha Sharma and 26 others for the degree of BA Honours in Psychology, Abhilasha Saxena and 73 others for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Arunima Geetai for Advanced Diploma in Counseling and Guidance, Sanskriti Sharma and 9 others for Advanced Diploma in Fashion Designing, Niti Rajani and Meenakshi Narayanan for Advanced Diploma in French, Pratibha Vishnoi and 2 others for Advanced Diploma in Jewelry Designing, Abhilasha Singh and 2 others for Advanced Diploma in Mass Communication and Video Production, Nandini Kumavat for Advanced Diploma in Visual Arts Painting.
My worship authority vested in me as a staff at IIS University, I admit you to the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Philosophy, Master of Arts, Fashion and Technology, Master of Journalism and Mass Communication, Master of Social Work, Master of Visual Arts, Master of Arts, Bachelor of Journalism and Mass Communication, Bachelor of Visual Arts, Bachelor of Arts Honours, Bachelor of Arts and Advanced Diploma, and mentioned by the Dean, Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences of this university. And all other graduates who have been declared qualified for the same by the university. I direct you to prove worthy of the same throughout your life by acts and behavior appropriate for your degree, diploma. In token thereof, we have been presented with these degrees, diplomas, and I authorize you to wear the robes as the insignia of your degree, diploma.
recipients of degrees and diplomas may now take their seats. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, in my capacity as the registrar of the university, I now request the Dean Faculty of Commerce and Management to present the graduates in the Faculty of Commerce and Management for conferment of their degrees and diplomas by the Chancellor. I request the Dean to present the recipients of the research degree of PhD first, and then the merit position holders of different programs at postgraduate level, and thereafter the merit position holders of the professional honors and past course programs at the undergraduate level in the Faculty of Commerce and Management for award of degree in person. The merit position holders of postgraduate diploma in management and different advanced diploma courses of career-oriented and skill development programs may then be presented for the award of diplomas in person. After that, all the graduates and the faculty may be presented for conferment of their degrees and diplomas by the Chancellor. Dean, Faculty of Commerce and Management, Professor M.K. Sharma.